Audio Sync, Audio Sync, you know what it is, what it does, it's that guy, not Locks. And I'm here doing another Dread review, of course, with it being Thursday, we got another review on the way. You guys know what it is, it's been highly requested by like one guy over time and over time, so I'm finally gonna get to it and do this video of boots. Insane Clown Posse, ICP for the win, ICPFTW. Definitely a legendary hip-hop group, and definitely have a legendary set of locks for our Caucasians. So make sure you stay tuned, stay subscribed, because this is the best in not lock content. Talking about dreads and shit, you want to see my own? Look at this one, man. Look at this dreadlock, man. It's really fat and ting. Got some nice locks going on, man. Check out this one, man. This one, what do you notice about it, man? You might notice that it has rubber bands on it. Very similar to how Insane Clown Posse rubber banded their dreads. Hey guys, welcome to the channel. It's Not Locks, and I'm here Monday through Friday. Definitely doing dread reviews on Tuesdays and Thursdays. Marijuana related cannabis videos on Mondays and Wednesdays and Freeform Fridays. If you haven't checked out my vlog channel, make sure you go over there, link in the description. It's definitely on the daily. Lots of vlogs every day. It's like day in the life of Not Locks all the time. What we're here talking about today is dreadlocks. Definitely doing the video on Insane Clown Posse. Insane Clown Posse. Been requested for a while, my bad on the delay, but it's finally happening today. So let's get right into this video. Insane Clown Posse is an American hip-hop duo from Detroit, Michigan. The group is composed of Joseph Bruce and Joseph Utzler, who perform under respective personas of the Wicked Clowns, Violent J, and Shaggy 2 Dope. Associated at record label Psychopathic Records, Island Records, Hollywood Records, Jive Records. These guys were very prominent in the 1990s, actually, the late 90s hip-hop duo from Detroit. Awesome to see that they're pretty close by as well. Definitely interesting to see a dread review on white males here, because there hasn't been too many. And these guys are dreading without the freeform process though. So let's take a look at what we are dealing with in this situation. I think these guys are most knownly here with this hairdo. More recently anyways, a blonde hair, and this guy here who has the rubber banded dreads. As we can see, and it's the way that he's done this that's very interesting, because looking at his locks, his hair has been separated into like twists almost, but not twisted, but he basically just rubber banded it all the way down and then dyed it. This is crazy, because you know what, it's a real roundabout way, but it will work to make dreads over the long term if he kept doing his hair like this. Is it the best way to make dreads? No, probably not, but it is an alternative method to see how they would turn out. If you just left them in rubber bands like this, they will be crinkly and they will be like scarred because of the band itself. But he seemed to have pulled it off in the past. Looking at some of the older pictures here, or I guess at random, we can see here that his hair is kind of twisted still, and looks like it was rubber banded as well when his hair was short and into locks. And I think this is how this guy was mainly making his locks at this stage. This is a cool picture, because this is locks when he's older, and he actually has them braided back, kind of like MJD. And it's really cool to see how he's pulled it off. Even the frizzy hair, it looks not so bad. He's got really big parts though on his scalp, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's kind of too boxy for braids. Checking out these photos here, you can see that his locks are a lot thicker at this point, over here as well. I feel that when they're younger, they had a fuller set of hair, hence why this guy now rocks his hair really short, but these dreads are still prominent. And notice the rubber bands are less, but the rest of his hair has started to dread up, but there's still rubber bands, and it's cool to see that he's dyed them with the rubber bands on. It's pretty sick. These guys definitely holding it down for unique set of locks. I know both of them had locks once upon a time, and I'm not sure if Shaggy 2 Dope here started his locks like so, you know, which is the basic squared off sectioning, and then it looks like he's like twisted it or rubber banded his hair or gelled it to keep it locked and keep them growing out like that. Whatever their method was, they seem to have nailed it pretty well in the 90s. Another photo here, you can see that his roots are just straight hair growing in, but he does have the locks happening in the back, and his hair grows to the back as well. So I mean, the rubber band method seemed to be working pretty well for these guys. This picture here, you can see his hair is like not even locked really. It's more of a baby face, baby dread stage. More recently, you can see that these have shaved heads entirely. They're not rocking the dreads no more at all. Shaggy 2 Dope here, more of the rubber band style locks all the time here. He's just kept them in rubber bands. And looking at his dreads here, again, you can see that they're rubber banded as well. Kind of greasy looking too. In the older stages of these dreads, these guys both had really long ones, and these specifically could have been just grown out through that same sectioning method that they've been doing, as we've seen in these pictures. Shaggy 2 Dope here on the right, his dreads look a lot thicker back in the day as well, as opposed to what he was rocking in the recent years. In the same Count Posse picture, once again, you can see how thick his locks are here. Same with this dude as well, very thick and a lot longer actually. Could have been even backcombed at this point, how thick they are, but you can still see rubber bands. He's been big on the rubber bands. Same with that photo. Once again, the braids looks actually pretty dope. He pulled it off really well. You don't see white dudes rocking the braid locks so often, so it's great to see that happening. Once again, another picture with the same picture with the rubber bands on the dreads itself. So I mean, I actually couldn't find too many photos, but I do believe that this guy started his locks like this, and he would have just kept them growing out while they've been sectioned like this, and he could have been even teasing the roots. So yeah. That's about all the images I could find on Insane Clown Posse, to be honest. There wasn't a whole lot to choose from. I like this picture because he's itching his head because he knows those dreadlocks are itchy. They get itchy. You gotta take care of that. Definitely need to take care of those itches. And we see them here enjoying some medicine, smoking out the jar. Why not? And it seems to be... that's the case here. Seems to be that all she wrote. So coming back to that itchy picture with him itching his scalp, I wanted just to mention that, you know what, over the past couple weeks I have myself been itching my scalp quite a bit because my dermatosis psoriasis was acting heavy on my head, and it was like flaking a lot. Today is like, you know what, it's honestly like 90% better than what it was before I did like a little treatment on my scalp. And what I did was I used olive oil in the microwave. I heated it up for a little bit so it's not burning hot, but it was warm. And I used one of these cotton balls, and I just like dabbed it and I wiped it around my problem area where I was having dry scalp and flakiness. I let that sit on my head for like half an hour. You can let it sit overnight. Just wrap your head in a bag so it doesn't drip down your neck. And then I showered and I rinsed it with apple cider vinegar and I washed it all out and I made sure it was all out. And it worked like almost to the perfect point. But you know what? I could use another treatment and it would probably be really good for the next few days up to a week. But I'm finding that olive oil is your best friend when it comes to locks that have already locked. If you're just starting your locks, you don't want to use olive oil because it's going to lubricate it too much and your locks aren't going to stick. So it's not a good remedy for newly dreads. But if you got mature locks, I would suggest trying a little bit of olive oil, heat it up as a hot oil treatment, and use it on your scalp for those itchy moments. But you know what it is, it's not locked. I'm going to sign off. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. Come back again tomorrow. I got a Freeform Friday video. And definitely check out the vlogs channel, link in the description. I got a new vlog coming out tomorrow, the next day, the day after, and for the rest of my life. Until then, I'll see you next time. Not Nation, salute, stay happy, stay nappy. And definitely holla at you, holla back. I'll see you next time. Whiz pieces.